And as our next presenter, we're actually going to continue on that topic, and we're going to have the Foundation for Natural Leadership here, which does exactly that, talk to people and try to connect the corporate world and the nature conservation and wilderness sector. So I would like to welcome Boy von Troffela, and who will start the presentation.
Yeah, perfect. All right. Well, thank you for hosting us. I enjoyed the Wilderness Week a lot. I'm going to talk about the benefits of the wilderness on leadership, so on us. And there's a foundation who is organizing trails. I will talk about it much longer later. And that is called the Foundation of Natural Leadership, which is facilitating trails for leaders all over the world. A little bit about myself. I'm a Dutchman. Live in Amsterdam. I'm now in Amsterdam, and married for 30 years. Very grateful for that. And we have a son, 20 years old. And I'm the chairman of the Foundation of Natural Leadership. Always have been an entrepreneur. And like 15 years ago, I met a guy, and he was already doing trails. And he said, you know, do you want to join a leadership trail into the bush? And I immediately intuitively knew that it was something for me. And I went to South Africa, to the Umvelosi National Park. And that was for me a life-changing event. It was amazing how it changed my life. I got a new perspective. And nowadays I'm also a facilitator of trails. So I take leaders of different organizations into the wilderness. About the Foundation of Natural Leadership, our roots, it was founded in 2002, and there was an international dialogue conference, and the conference was about how can we get better leaders. And they found out it was among Peter Senge, Jaworski, Jane Goodall, Ian Player. And they said, the best thing you can do for a leader is to get them into nature and learn from nature. And that is exactly what our mission is. There's a big question about who am I? And we think that we can learn a lot from nature, and we can learn what our own nature is by being in nature. And that is, nature is such a big gift for human beings. We have leaders from profit organization, non-profit organization. So there's a variety of people we bring into the wilderness. And from 2002 till now, we have about 1,500 people who joined us on a trail. There is a video, but I show you later. What we do is we have a program and we go for a week into nature. And like we start with the life story of a person. So the big question is, who am I? And you are not your curriculum, you know, you are not, I worked from there, from 2002 to 2008 for Philips company and so on. No, it's about who are you without, you know, your mental things. And so you start, for instance, with your life story, and then coming into nature that week, we cook ourselves, we drink water from the rivers. It's very, very basic, sometimes very challenging, but especially because if it's challenging, you come closer to yourself and start enjoying it. our first partner, we had two speakers this morning of the Wilderness Leadership School. Our first partner was the Wilderness Leadership School in South Africa. And we are very grateful that they are a big partner, because we learn a lot about nature from them. And they have, you know, they are nature themselves. So that is a great example, and very inspiring. What happens when we go for a week into the nature is that you as an individual go, we call it the 30U, which is founded by Jaworski, Peter Senge, and Otto Scharmer. So in the beginning, you have to let go all your mental thoughts and all your standard solutions for things. And that is kind of letting go, and sometimes emotional, painful, but slowly but surely, after a couple of days, you come into more into yourself and start enjoying nature, and your senses go open, and there are emerging new solutions. And in the end of the trail of the 7 days, we also make it very concrete on a few levels. So for you personal, what does it mean for me as my person? What am I going to do to keep this feeling? On a private level, that is in your family, maybe your close friends, what I'm going to do there. And then on your professional level and your work, what am I going to change or do there? And finally, in the public domain, how can I contribute to society? What we do, we have trails in Europe, like in Spain, in Italy, and in Switzerland. We have trails in South Africa, in Botswana and Rwanda. We do so-called wilderness quests. That is, you go into the wilderness and that you have a solo experience for 24 hours. You're there completely alone with only water and some nuts. We do a lot now, I come back to it later, what the influence is of the now challenging times, but there's a demand for closer trails in the Netherlands. We do in company programs, we do trails for people who has been on trails, and we organize circle gatherings now online as well. These are a couple of the regions where we go to. You see the Swiss, it's Italy, Marataba, where I've been. Well, you see all the different, all amazing, amazing wildernesses and experience. I go back a little bit I have a little video which is nice to showed, and you can see this is a trail in Spain, and you can see a little bit how it goes, what we do.
No one knows me, it's a necessary thing, it's a place I made up, found out what I made of, the nights I've stayed. Counting stars and fighting sleep, let it wash over me. I'm ready to lose my feet. Take me off to the place where one reviews life's mystery. Steady on down the line, lose every sense of time. Take it all in, wake up, that's my part of me. Day to day I'm blind to see and find how far to go. Everybody got their reason, everybody got their way. We're just catching and releasing what builds up throughout the day. It gets into your body and it flows right through your blood. We can tell each other secrets and remember how to love. Da da dum da dum dum dum. Da dum dum dum. Da dum dum. da da dum da dum dum da dum 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 da dum dum.
Thank you.
Okay, you can take it from here again. You just have to share your screen again to see your presentation.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Yeah. What is important when you saw this video, it's not only a walk in nature. So what we do is we share our emotions, we share what's coming up, we share in work what are your challenges, we share in your relationship or relationships what is coming up. So we have these circles with a talking stick. You can, you're only allowed to talk when you have the talking stick in your hand, and then you share what's coming up. And because you share it, you know, it goes away. It's kind of an acceptance. And you learn a lot from your peers in the group. So it's a kind of a therapy, you can call it, or a spiritual experience. And it's, for most of the people, it's a life-changing experience. It really changes their lives. Why are we doing it? Well, first of all, of course, to get to learn yourself, who am I? That's the natural leadership. That if you know yourself better, then you become a better leader. And that is has enormous impact on organizations. So when you are yourself sustainable, you live sustainable, and you want to have an organization that is sustainable. So we had, for instance, the CEO of Philips was on trail. We have young people, we have old people. We want to go to more international. So we are now in the process of more diversity in the groups. And if you have, when you have sustainable organization, of course that has an impact on a sustainable society. So that's basically why we want to do it. And we start with the individual, and then in the group, and then in the organization, and then in the society. We have challenges at this moment, our partners as well. And that is, you know, because of the virus, we have less trails. We are not able to travel a lot, definitely not outside Europe. And what we did is now we have virtual trails. So you can have a weekly program online. So you have coaching online. You have you can go outside your house and then. With a question. We have also online gatherings, which are very, very inspiring. And you know, one of the things, I don't know how about you, but it's very, when you have hard times, you get to know your partners as well. For instance, the Wilderness Leadership School, they have challenging times as well, but we can help each other now in mentally and maybe a little bit financially. So, that is for the future very, very nice. New opportunities are internationalization. So we are looking for partners in different countries who want to start maybe a foundation of natural leadership in their country. And if we can help them, we are very happy about that. And scientifically, Boy van Drofla is the next speaker. And So we are looking from what is the, if you look on a scientifically view, what is the impact on leaders? So it's not only a feeling that we think we have impact, but it's scientifically proved. And that is very special. So that is my story. I like to I love to share, and maybe there are some questions.
Yeah, thank you for that presentation. We already have the first question. Of course, people can still ask in the Q&A or just raise their hand to talk to you directly. Peter is saying that it seems clear that many of our political leaders need this, but are the least likely to put themselves in such a natural setting. How do you reach these people?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think I was in politics for a while, so I'm an example who went into nature of a politician. But I think the politicians are a reflection of ourselves. So I don't think we should point to politicians a lot, you know, then we can wait for ages. What is the name of the person who asked it?
Peter Dretsch.
Okay, maybe Peter, how do you look at a trail, and what is your, did you do a trail or do you want to do a trail?
Well, I work in the American government. I work for the US Fish and Wildlife Service, and yeah. I'm constantly briefing politicians, and I grew up in Washington, but it's very clear that most of the politicians who are receptive to this have had an experience in the natural world during their formative years. So they are often answering to a larger, they're not only listening to their constituents, they're listening to God, or they're listening to nature. And it means they're not always playing to the crowd. And how you bring that to in the current day, where there's so much noise, where there's such a barrage of unnatural information being dumped on people. I don't know how you get them clicked back in to the fact that there's a higher calling that they need to be listening to.
Yeah. My own experience is that everything is an expression of myself, right? And of yourself. So the only thing I can do is be close to my own nature. And that is what I can contribute to the society and to my close people. So I don't look at that much to politicians. What is your... What do you, are you a nature guy, or are you going into nature a lot? And what is your?
I'm a scientist in the government. So and it was during formative experiences in wild places that that gave me this calling. And not just in the, as you pointed out, it's not just a natural setting. It's the natural setting with a small group of people when you realize that. Whatever you contribute, it will be much more if you can find a band of people with whom to do it. That your own personal contribution will only take you so far, but it really is in finding this this combination of feedback from the natural world, but also from colleagues.
Exactly. And then you are in a position that you can influence it. I rather spend my energy on things I can directly influence than things that are happening I can't influence. Then I let it go.
Right. Yeah. Well, I think I look at all the young people who are running this meeting, and I see the passage of that we're passing the baton to them, and they, and I'm hoping that they have a set of values, values that I grew up with, that they have a set of values that will allow us to really face the enormous challenges that, you know, I think about the Netherlands, because I during my formative period, I was in Europe quite a lot. That's where I did my PhD. And you know, the moving from trying to constantly hold back nature to actually be part of it. I'm thinking of the Veluwe and the rewilding of the Veluwe, which was happening when I was a graduate student.
Yeah. No, that's great. Great to hear. And I'm very positive about the next generation. I think they will bring society further.
We actually have a question exactly on this topic from Cheryl. Cheryl, we allowed you to speak. So if you want to ask the question yourself, you can do so.
Hi, Vish. It's been enjoyable listening to you, knowing you so well. The question is, what would be the program now to galvanize the youth leadership as we have captains of industry to a degree trying to get to politicians and adults and in their development? How would we look at integrating youth to get the same benefits that the participants of the Foundation for Natural Leadership have done?
Yeah, yeah, that's exactly that is our challenge right now. How, because now it's you know, leaders 40 plus. So how do we get younger people in their 20s or 30s? For the challenge is the, to be honest, the price of the program for young people now, because traveling, for instance, to Africa or Switzerland, that costs quite a lot, and the program has also his value. We are now connecting to a group of young people who do it, and we want to learn from them how they do it, instead of that we, you know, our brain is too old maybe, and then we learn from them how to do it. Maybe we can we think about starting sponsoring, so that people who can afford it, that they sponsor young people. So things are, we talked with the Wilderness Leadership School, maybe we can bring young African, South African students or young people on trail with a couple of our guys, and maybe you in South Africa have some companies who want to sponsor it. So that are things that we are thinking about.
Thank you. It's a wonderful answer. Thanks, Vish.
Yeah. Do you have answers to this question?
Well, I think this sort of sits in the 65-year history of the Wilderness Leadership School. That is the ethos on which we've founded the legacy of constantly involving communities in Southern Africa on these wilderness trails. So we always find that it's of huge value to have young leaders within the community surrounding the parks, to involve them with other groups on these trails and in our training programs, because that intercultural experience is just invaluable. Yeah. So yes, that is very much where we would like to see the movement go.
Great. Yeah, great. Thanks.
Okay, we have our next question from Isaac. Isaac, do you want to speak up directly?
Oh, sure. So basically, I was wondering, because you talked a lot about leaders, corporate leaders, and going into nature, which I think is great, and bringing these people into having kind of almost, I guess, even a spiritual experience of nature, or having that deeper connection. Do you think they realize that ultimately our current economic system is and always will be fighting against wilderness?
you think that our economic system is fighting against wilderness?
Yeah, I think so. I think that with kind of like continuous growth and production, I think it will always seek to take up space that nature has previously taken up because it's not valued.
Yeah, if you do it in the old way, you mean, right? In the old fashioned way. I mean, there are also businesses that do it in a new fashioned way and they contribute to the wilderness. But let's say the in the old fashioned way, is that is exactly why we love them to go on trail, because during the trail they experience nature, and then you know they see the wildlife, they see the little flowers, they see the birds, and then they realize how beautiful it is and how balanced it is, and how if you don't do it right, if you don't have the right attitude, how the balance shifts to a negative side. So so they change their attitude towards nature, and they change their attitude into business. So it's great that they join us. And also we have a big group of people who have been on trail. So we have also workshops about the economy, the impact of the business on the wilderness, on the climate. So that is, it's changing. You take them along a changing world. That answers your question.
Okay, I think Isaac was happy with your answer.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that was a very interesting discussion.